Well, well, well. How the turntables.
What's up guys, Sal here. So the recent benchmark of the Galaxy S21 Ultra between the Exynos and Snapdragon variant suggests that while the Exynos has managed to slightly outperform the Snapdragon variant of the S21 Ultra in the CPU test, the GPU is where Qualcomm still dominates the Exynos in Samsung's latest flagships. Now, since both of these chipsets are made with 5nm nodes, which means regardless of which chipset you're getting, you're not gonna notice any performance disparity in either CPU or GPU demanding tasks. But what you're gonna notice is the battery life. For most people, battery life is more important than that millisecond of a difference while you're opening an app or performing any task. For the last few years, Samsung is struggling to compete with Qualcomm in this department. I mean, just last year, the Exynos 990 performed terribly against Snapdragon 865 in the battery test, where Snapdragon variants had almost an hour and a half of extra screen on time compared to Exynos, which was a massive difference for the same phone that also cost the same. But thankfully, with the S21 Ultra, the tables have turned. The Exynos is finally outperforming the Snapdragon in the battery test as well. PBK Reviews did a rigorous battery test between the Exynos and Snapdragon variants of the S21 Ultra. It lasted for 30 minutes where both of the phones had their display brightness settings cranked all the way up to the max. They've also turned off adaptive brightness support and other battery saving functionalities. The test also includes stress tests and performance tests. After 30 minutes, the battery on the Exynos was at 89% while it was 87% on the Snapdragon. Another issue the past Exynos phones had was they generate a lot of heat compared to their counterpart. This test indicates that Samsung has also addressed that issue. The battery heated up to 46.6 degrees Celsius by the end of this energy drain challenge. That's 3.4 degrees Celsius cooler than the S21 Ultra model running Snapdragon chipset. Now, these are not a big difference, and that's how it should be. We can say Samsung has finally made these two variants perform on par with each other, and that's a relief for Exynos regions who have been getting inferior products despite paying the same amount of money, or even more in some cases. Smartwatches have gained a lot of new health features recently, from heart rate monitor to ECG. But companies like Samsung aren't stopping just there. Their upcoming Galaxy Watch Active 4 will be capable of monitoring a person's blood glucose level. According to South Korean media AT News, Samsung will use an optical sensor in the Galaxy Watch Active 4 to measure the blood glucose level. The good thing about this is that it doesn't require users to draw blood. I mean, it doesn't require users to prick their fingers with a needle, which is often how the blood sugar is tracked. So this will be a revolutionary feature if it indeed works like the conventional blood sugar measuring system. Apple is also expected to have this feature on their next Apple Watch, but it will be Samsung to be the first of this technology. The Galaxy Watch Active 4 will be launched at the next Unpacked event, expected to happen in June, which will be headlined by the Galaxy Z Fold 3 and hopefully the Galaxy Note 21 Ultra. Of course, with that being said, do let me know what you think about this down in the comments. And as always, I'll see you tomorrow. Peace out.